I'm going to show you a couple tricks I've learned along the way with Sketch. Sketch and a craft plugin is what I'm using if you're interested. So let's get started. Click on the A, click on Sketch, and then click on the letter A, and you'll see over here you have some artboard options. So I've gone ahead and clicked on the iPhone 7. I'm going to do the same thing 4 times. Now I have 4 artboards. To zoom in and out, you can use Command Plus and Command Minus. So I'm going to start zooming in, click on the artboard you want to work on, and click on the letter R to make a rectangle. So here we have a rectangle. Sketch has a cool thing where it does like a border by default and a color. So right now I don't want a border, but I do want to pick a color. So you can go ahead, pick a color you like. I think that one's good. When you're done, just click that color and this should go away. Click on it, the letter T, and you'll have some text, so you can say my app. We're just going to use some dummy text. If you want to center this, you can use this button over here. So that looks good. I'd like to make a hamburger menu, so I'm going to use the R that we used before. And just make a little little rectangle. I'm going to make it white with no border. It's a little wide, so I'm going to just, you can use the down arrow here, it's a lot faster. And if you click on something, you can use your arrow keys to move around. If you hold shift, they go a little faster. So here's the regular and here's with shift. You can see quite a difference. So another thing I'm going to do here is round the radius. Do you see how we have rounded corners? So hold that and Alt, and then do Command D to do that again. And we're going to go ahead and group this by selecting only the items we want, right clicking and saying group. That means you can then scale this as a group, which is nice. Another thing I'd like to do is I'd like to make this a symbol. So I have to, again, group, and then right-click and say create symbol. So I'm going to call this top bar. It's okay to keep this on your symbols page. I'll show you, that's right here. So your symbols page has your top bar. You can also always access it by double-clicking on the symbol in your app. So say you wanted to change this, so you can say new app. You can center this, maybe you can center this, and then return to instance. There you go. So your symbol has carried over. So here we're going to go insert, symbol, top bar, and we're going to just put that in there, same place. So one cool thing is you can check your coordinates. So your position here is 0, 0, so check this, look, we're a little bit out of whack, so I'm going to make it 0, 0 again. And then I'm going to do the same thing, insert, symbol, top bar, click that down there, I'm going to go 0, 0, and then, oops, so let's copy this here, let's go insert, symbol, top, perfect. So what's cool now, let's just ignore that one. What's cool now is if you, my extra new app, if you make changes, instead of having to do that every time, you see the changes are reflected across all your artboards. So now I'd like to make a card. So I'm going to go ahead and draw the card with, I just clicked the R rectangle tool and then drew it out like before. I'm going to do another rectangle here. Oops, it's a little wonky. It's okay, we'll fix it. So, roughly the size I was going for. I'd like some text, so I'm going to click on the letter T. I'm going to say title text. I'd like this text to be dark though, so I'm going to do that. Drag it down. Oops, sorry. No, title text. Okay, it's gonna make us type again. Sorry, guys. If you ever get lost, like you can say I'm lost here, just grab on the left. It's cool. It has your layers. I said that like it would totally work, and it did not work. Please excuse me. So here, I'm gonna click on this and hold Alt, and then it's going to make a copy. I'm going to go ahead and make this text smaller, and this is going to be, this is my body text. And what you'll see here is it's now wrapping. I don't want that, so I'm going to make this a little smaller, and you see my text wraps. So I'm going to paste this so there's more. Another thing you can change is the line height over here. I really like increasing my line height. I think it makes things look a lot more modern. So here, we're going to use a cool plugin called Craft. And we have, so I've just clicked on that. You can download it online. It's free. You can also pick here in the photo section. There's a lot of, it's really good for making quick prototypes. So say we want to have pictures of food. So just go ahead and click on food. You see down here it says download an image from Unsplash. You know, I don't like that one, so I'd like another picture of food, so I clicked it a second time. That one looks great. Here, you see my outlines? I don't really like them, so I'm going to go ahead and select them and then unclick the borders. So now that's gone. If you want to change the opacity of text, there's a really easy way. You highlight it and then click a number on your keyboard between 1 and 10. So here I'm clicking 1, 9, 3. So I'd like it to be like a 4, I think, and I'd like this to be an 8. So my text is a little more subtle. I'd also like this to not be the default gray. I'd like it to be like a slightly lighter gray. Awesome. So I'm gonna highlight all these and then hold Alt and Shift and make a copy. So I'm paying close attention to the margin, so 18. And then I'm gonna go Command D to repeat that. So you see what I've done there? It just, and it also, it's nice how it just falls off the edge. So now with the Craft plugin, I'm going to auto-populate these with some photos of food by clicking on food. I selected them all. Oops, apparently I didn't. I selected some of them. So we're going to do that one more time. There we go. So it's very easy to just go in here and then say, yeah, these are blueberries, some kind of biscuit. I don't know how to spell biscuit. There, biscuit. No idea what this is. Croissant? And pizza, perhaps. Pizza, maybe. So you can see this all looks very nice. So now, not to waste your time, but I'd like to show you another way of doing that. And we're going to start here, and that's just by using the symbols method. So we're going to group it, we're going to make a symbol, we're going to call it card, and then we're going to go insert, symbol, card, and then we're just, let's make the margins a little less. So if you're paying attention, you can see my margins are a little weird. So I'll teach you a trick here. So I'm going to make this margin what I think it should be, and I'm going to select all of these, and then I'm going to distribute here. Beautiful. So what I've done here is symbols, which makes it a little different. So I have to choose an image from my library. Luckily, I have a library. Unfortunately, it's not of food. It's of headshots. So we're going to choose some photos here. And it's just a little bit of a different way of working, so once you get used to it, you'll probably be more okay with all the different ways of this working. So here you would type in, you know, her name, his name, other name, name. So you can see how, and then you can, you know, change body text here. So that's one way. Another way, and we're just going to copy this non-symbol one to show you another cool, like, oops, let's try again. Let's select this, I got to select this artboard, select these items, and then paste it. It's not quite pasting this, don't worry about it. So let's say that pasted where we wanted it to. Obviously did not. go a little lower. Perfect. If I wanted to change, like say I wanted names of people, my craft plugin is perfect for that. And it, over here you click on type and you click on names. And you say male or female, or both. And you see it populated with names. You can also do headlines about cooking, which is kind of cool. Headlines about cooking. If you wanted to, you could even make, you know, a smaller section. It's like darker maybe. Oops, I forgot that's opacity, so it's hit 9. And then say you want to do an article about cooking. So I'm going to delete some of this other stuff so it doesn't get too crazy. But this is quite a powerful tool. So feel free to have fun with it. You can also, you know, say you want this to be more of a header. Yeah, it's kind of a bad picture, but let's try it again. Let's use our food photos. There you go. Cooking with fine Italian wine. I really like all the capability that Sketch has. I don't know why I have a gradient. That's a little weird. Oh, because it's a poop? That's quite strange. So let's set it to 100% and see if that changes. I don't know why we have this weird mask thing happening right now. It looks like it's bucket filled with... Okay, I filled it with an image. Okay, don't do that, but everything else, yeah, that's quite cool. So, I hope you've enjoyed this crash course in Sketch. If you have any questions at all, feel free to drop me a line. Have fun working with symbols. If you ever want to see where your symbols are, they're over here. And as usual, if you wanted to change something, like the color of your text, maybe you want it to be blue, bright blue, because that would look cool. You can see all cards are we use the symbol half bright blue, so hit Command Z and it'll undo. Maybe you want all your cards to have rounded corners because that's cool. So it's very easy. This is a very, very efficient tool. So pretty much that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. I'd be happy to answer. Let me know what you'd like to learn and have fun with Sketch. Take care. Bye, guys.